Hello, greetings. This is Gilles Mancion. I said I come and say hello. Wish you a good day. I didn't have time too much to think about the video. I'm kind of more on a relaxed mode today. But I feel there is a great deal of that is happening, that is ready to change. And so we want to be in a receptive mode as much as possible. Always ready to receive inspiration, receive guidance, receive wisdom. To always be in this receptive mode. It's going to be important to always move in this. To always be receptive does not mean we want to lose out our creative power. There is this powerful conjunction of Saturn and Pluto in Capricorn that is coming together very, very closely. There is this conjunction between the Sun and the Moon, of this new Moon, and in between there is a conjunction of Jupiter, Venus, and the galactic center. Personally, I had Venus and Jupiter conjuncting in my natal chart, so it's like it always feels good to have those two planets come together because they make it very obvious what's really good for us. For right now, Venus is in Sagittarius, it's going to be moving into Capricorn, or it is moving into Capricorn, so it's going to be more like business. We're going to be more like Venus, those things we love. I'm more move from philosophical ideas to practical ideas, so we're going to be able. I'm going to put back my suit and tie and go to work very soon. I'm really looking forward to that. To wear a suit and tie in a business place, it's almost to be a rebel in our days and age because there is this wind coming from the Silicon Valley. Everybody has to wear t-shirts and shorts and slipper or sneaker at work. But in a workplace, I do prefer when people are working personally. I feel more comfortable in a workplace in wearing working clothes, business clothes. So I'm going to be happy to return to that business environment. I'm going to pull a few cards to provide an oracle. For the highest wisdom is the triumph. There is this triumphant energy. We've done a lot of work. Now it's about moving forward with these energies. What we need to understand is patience. There is things only comes when it is in due time. Things come in divine timing. What we need to do is the light. We need to be one with the light, to be in the light, to be the light. And the outcome is accomplishment. So we're going to complete the cycle and find this accomplishment that we're seeking to, and we'll be ready to move into something completely new next year. Well, I hope this message was interesting for you. Make it short today. This is a portrait of Piet Mondrian. It's a study, he's got his pipe. And it's a study of Piet Mondrian. I've done two of those. I was going to put them in ink, the portrait, but I think the paper, the pencil may be enough. I'm going to keep it as a study. And this is a painting I started, a small painting on the seven families of spirit beings. It's in a gray tones. I've been influenced by a painting, a portrait. I'm thinking about working on this portrait of Claude Monet, which is impressionist. I'm working with a lot of gray tones. And I just wanted to come and say hello. Well, thank you for liking, sharing, commenting, subscribing. Finish with a song and pull one more last card. This song is called Dust in the Wind. It reminds us that everything is just dust. We're made of this stardust and we come from the light and we come into form and then we're going to return into the light eventually. It goes like this. I close my eyes only for a moment and the moment's gone. All my dreams pass before my eyes, a curiosity, dust in the wind. All there is dust in the wind, same old song. Just a drop of water in an endless sea. All we do crumbles to the ground, though we refuse to see. Dust in the wind. All we are is dust in the wind. Now don't hang on. Nothing lasts forever but the earth and sky. It sleeps away. And all your money won another minute by. Dust in the wind. All we are is dust in the wind. Dust in the wind. Everything is just dust in the wind. That's a nice song from, I think it was a band named Kansas. Soon we're gonna click our slippers and we'll no longer be in Kansas, like Dorothy in The Wizard of Oz. We're gonna return home. Sometimes I wonder, is it just a matter of just clicking our heels three times and we're back home in heaven? Maybe that's all it takes. The card of the day is the Six of Ariel. Your material needs are fulfilled in a way that is unexpected as by magic. Signs of kindness, to give and to receive with gratitude and acknowledgement. So it's about accepting the miracles, accepting that life can be magic and miraculous. I thank you very much. I wish you a wonderful day, a wonderful new moon, and I'll talk to you later. Namaste.